Hello students, so in this video we are going to solve some of the important theorems which can directly be applied on any of the questions. Okay, so here is the first important theorem, which is internal angle bisector theorem. Okay, so the statement of this theorem says that it divides the opposite side in the ratio of the sides containing the angle. Means if we draw an angle bisector here, look, in this figure AD is the internal bisector. Okay, so angle 1 is equals to angle 2, then it says that the side, the opposite side, that is BC, in the way the BC is divided, like same way AB and AC is divided. Okay, means they are in same proportion. So what we have to prove here, that BD upon DC is equals to AB upon AC, AB upon AC, because these are the sides that are containing the angle. Okay, so for that, for the proofing of this, first we need a construction here. So what we will construct, we will construct a line from C, from this point up to E, which is parallel to line AD. Okay, which will be parallel to this line AD. So we will construct a line here and we will join it in this way. Okay, so this is our E point. Okay, name this angle as angle 3 and this angle is angle 4. Okay, so now these two lines, AD is parallel to CE. Okay, and AC is transversal. So if two lines are parallel and a transversal is drawn, their alternate interior angles are equal. Wherever you found the Z-like structure, its internal angles are equal. This is called internal angle bisector. Okay, alternate interior angle, sorry. So here angle 2 will be equals to angle 3 by alternate interior angle. Okay, now look at the figure. These two lines are parallel to each other like this. Okay, and BE is transversal, means we can say that AD is parallel to CE and BE is transversal. Okay, if this line is transversal, then we can say that angle 4 is equals to angle 1, means angle 4 is equals to angle 1. Okay, by corresponding angles. So these are the theorems, or these are the identities that we have already used on parallel lines. Okay, so if two lines are parallels, then their alternate interior angles are equal, their corresponding angles are equal, and this is what we have applied here. Okay, so now we have angle 2 is equals to angle 3 and angle 4 is equals to angle 1. Also angle 1 is equals to angle 2 because AD is bisector. Okay, this is what we are proving. So if it is bisector, means both the angles are equal. So from this conclusion, can we say that angle 2 is equals to angle 4? Okay, but angle 2 is equals to angle 3 here. So here we can say that it is equals to angle 3. Now look at the figure here, angle 3 and angle 4, both these angles are equal. Okay, so the sides opposite to these angles will be equal. So side opposite to angle 4 is AC and side opposite to angle 3 is side AE. So we can say that AC is equals to AE. This is our conclusion. Okay, so now look at the figure. If we take entire triangle, that is EBC, in this triangle AD line is parallel to CE, so we can apply BPT here. Okay, so now let me write here that in triangle EBC, which line? AD is parallel to CE. Okay, so by BPT we can, what we will write here, that BD upon CD is equals to AB upon AE. Okay, by basic proportionality theorem, that is BPT or Thales theorem. Okay, but we know that here AC is equals to AE, so in place of AC, AE, we can write AC. So we can say that BD upon BD upon CD is equals to AB upon AC. And this is what we have to prove. Look here. Okay. So it is proved. What we have done here, we have applied the rules of parallel lines. If these two lines are parallel, their alternate interior angles are equal. If these two lines are parallel, their corresponding angles are equal. So by these two conclusions, we can say that angle 3 is equals to angle 4. It means that AEC is an isosceles triangle and as sides opposite to equal angles are equal. So from here we get AC is equals to AE. Now we have applied BPT to the full triangle, that is EBC. So this divided by this is equals to AB divided by AE, and AE is equals to AC. So we can say that BD upon DC is equals to AB upon AC. Okay. Yes, students. So now we will move to another important theorem, which is external angle bisector theorem. So what is the statement of this theorem? It states that the external angle bisector of an angle divides the opposite side. Means, look, ABC is our triangle. Okay. If we draw an external angle bisector, look, this is external angle. So if we draw a bisector here, means angle 1 is equals to angle 2, and this side, the third side is produced to meet this point, okay, meet the angle bisector at D. Okay, so here BC upon DC, BD upon DC is equals to AB upon AC. Okay, this is what we have to prove. Okay, so for proofing, we need a construction here. So what we will construct a line EC parallel to AD. Okay, we will draw a line here that it will be parallel to AD. Okay, this is the line. So now we have here this, name this angle as 3 and this angle as 4. Okay, this is our 3 angle and this is 4th angle. So now, can you see a Z like structure here? Like this, this is the Z. Okay, so angle 1 is equals to angle 3. Angle 1 is equals to angle 3, alternate interior angles. Okay, now look, these two lines are parallel, extend these lines like this. Okay, so look, this is angle 2 and this is angle 4. So from here we can say that angle 2 is equals to angle 4, okay, by corresponding angles. Okay, so from here we have angle 2 is equals to angle 4 and angle 1 is equals to angle 3, but it is already given that angle 1 is equals to angle 2 because it is a bisector. Okay, so angle 1 will be equals to angle 2. Now from here, can we say that angle 3 is equals to angle 4? Okay, by these two, we can say that angle 1 is equals to angle 4. Okay, and then by these two, angle 1 can be written as angle 3. So angle 3 is equals to angle 4. Okay, now these two angles are equal, so the sides opposite to equal angles are equal. This we have learnt already. Okay, so from here the side opposite to angle 3 is, this is point AE. So AE is equals to angle 4. The side opposite to angle 4 is AC. Okay, so this is our conclusion. Now in this triangle, if we take, look here, in triangle ABD, this is our triangle. Now we have a line which is parallel to one side of triangle, that is EC is parallel to AD. So we can apply BPT here. So by BPT, basic proportionality theorem, we can say that BC upon CD, okay, or BE upon AE. Look, let me write BE upon AE. These two sides, because a parallel line divides it in same proportion. So BC upon CD is equals to BC upon CD. Now look at the proofing here. We need BD upon DC. Okay. So BC upon DC or CD, it is same. So in place of BC, we need a BD here. So this is BC we need entire BD here. So if we add both of them, BC plus CD, okay, so we will get BD at numerator. So we will add 1 to here and 1 here. Okay, now we can do anything to both side of equal sign by Euclid's postulates. So here this can be written as BE plus AE upon AE is equals to BC plus CD upon CD. Okay, so now look at the figure. BE plus AE is nothing but AB. So in place of this, we can write AB upon AE, which is equals to BC plus CD is nothing but BD. So BD upon CD. Okay, now we also have AE is equals to AC. So here we can write here AB upon AC is equals to BD upon CD. And this is external angle bisector theorem. Okay, so remember bachcho, these two theorems can directly be applied on any question. Okay, if there is angle bisector, if it is internal angle, then you can use internal angle bisector theorem. If it is not, then use external angle bisector theorems. Now like congruency, we have learnt about five criterions, I think. Okay, RHS, SSS, SAS, ASA and angle. So here in similarity, if all the angles of two triangles are equal, then we can say that these two triangles are similar. Okay, so first of all, look, you don't need to check it for all three angles. If two angles are equal, then you can use angle similarity. Okay, angle similarity, because if two angles of triangles are equal, then third will be equal by default. Okay, so third will be automatically proved. So here we can say angle similarity. Look here, if ABC is our triangle, this is A, this is B and this is C, and we have another triangle which is D, E and F. Okay, so if angle A is equals to angle D and angle B is equals to angle E, so we can say that triangle ABC is similar. This sleeping S is the sign of similarity. It is equals to, look, A is equals to D, so here we can write D here. Okay, B is equals to E, so B is equals to E, and in place of C, F. Okay, we can say that these two are similar by angle similarity, because third will automatically be equal by default. Okay, so if these two triangles are similar, we can take their corresponding sides as equal. We can take their sides as proportion. So sides, by this you have to remember bachcho, this is very important. Look, AB upon DE, so AB upon DE is equals to BC upon EF, is equals to BC upon EF. Okay, is equals to AC upon DF, so AC upon DF. Okay, so this is the conclusion we get by similarity. Okay, we can take all the sides as in proportion, in equal proportion. Okay, so this is nothing but our angle similarity, or we can say that angle axiom. Okay, so if two pair of angles of a triangles are equal, then we can use angle similarity. Okay, it is just like the congruency that you have learnt in your previous class. Okay, so this is the conclusion, and I think this is your theorem number 6.3. okay, so now let's move to another criterion, which will be SAS similarity. Look, before that you need to know about one more thing. Look, let me write here. Look, this is your triangle, which is, so this is A, this is B, this is C, and this is another triangle which is D, E and F. Look, if angle A is equals to angle F, okay, and angle B is equals to angle D, then we can write triangle ABC is similar to triangle, look, in place of A we have to write F, because angle A is equals to angle F. So here we will write F, then b is equals to d, so in place of b we will write d, and c is by default equals to e, so fd. So here we can say that triangle ABC is similar to triangle FDE, and which sides are in proportion? Look, AB upon FD is equals to BC upon DE is equals to AC upon FE. Okay, so in this way you have to write about the triangles. Okay, we cannot write here DEF because angle A is equals to angle F, so in place of A we have to write F, in center it is B, so B is equals to D. Okay, and C is by default equals to E. Okay, now let's move to a another similarity, which will be your theorem number 4th, I think. Okay, so here if a pair of angle is equal, look, like ABC, and here it is triangle DEF. Okay, so if angle A is equals to angle D, these are equal. Angle A is equals to angle D, it is given. Okay, and another thing, the sides are in proportion which are containing the angles, means AB upon AC is equals to ED upon DF. Okay, AB upon AC is equals to ED upon DF. Then only we can say that triangle ABC is similar to triangle, look, A is equals to D, so here D, now AB upon AC, so AB upon AC is equals to ED upon DF, so AB is equals to ED, okay, and AC is equals to DF, so here we can write in place of BC, this is BC, we have to write EF, so DEF, okay, so this is the way to use SAS similarity. Okay, now the last axiom, which says that it is equals by side congruency side similarity. So it is very simple, because if all the sides of a triangle are in proportion, then only we can say that look, this is D, this is E, this is F. Okay, if all the sides, means AB upon any side, look, we can take AB upon EF is equals to BC upon FD is equals to AC upon DE. Okay, so here, look, this is AB line, this is EF. So triangle A, B and C is equals to triangle, not equals, is similar to triangle. Look, in place of B, we have to write E in place of A, because AB here and it here is EF. Okay, so in place of A is E and B is F. So E, F and by default D. Okay, so these two triangles are similar. Okay, so these are the axioms that you have to apply directly on the questions. So in our next video, we will solve some of the related questions to these theorems or axioms. Okay, so in this video, we have learned about two theorems. Those were internal angle bisector theorem. Another is external angle bisector theorem. Then three axioms. First is angle-angle similarity. Second is side-angle-side similarity, in which one pair of angle is equal and other two pairs of sides are in proportion, okay, which are containing the angle. That is most important. Okay, those sides must contain the angle. Okay, look here, these sides must contain the angles. Okay,